أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام را، كتاب أحكمت آياته ثم فصلت من لدن حكيم خبير. ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إنني لكم منه نذير وبشير. صدق الله العظيم. With the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and invoking His help, we are starting the study of Surah Uhud alayhi salatu wa salam. As I told you, Surah Yunus and Surah Uhud alayhi salatu wa salam are a pair. They have the same relationship between them which we found in Surah Al-An'am and Surah Al-A'raf. There we found only Hazrat Ibrahim mentioned in Surah Al-An'am. None of those messengers to whose nations the punishment of Allah came. And Surah Al-A'raf, nearly half of it, that was occupied by Ambaw Rusul, the history of those nations to whom the messengers of Allah were sent, and they rejected them and they were destroyed. And here we find, you know, that although it's not so clear-cut, you know, polarization or differentiation, but a reciprocal ratio exists. In Surah Yunus, only two of 11 sections, they were occupied by Ambaw Rusul, the history of the messengers. Here in Surah Hud, we'll find more than half of the surah again, just like Surah Al-A'raf. It deals with the history of those nations and people and the messengers which sent to them. Both these surahs are starting Alif Lam Ra, and I didn't remember to invite your attention to this fact. The Alif Lam Ra is not counted as a full ayah. While Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran, though both of them began with Alif Lam Meem, and in both of them Alif Lam Meem, it is one ayah, counted as one ayah. Alif Lam Ra, not counted as one ayah. Ha Meem, although they are two letters, they are counted as one ayah. All these things are based on as the Prophet told us. Not any rule of grammar, nor any rule of linguistics, not any rule of nahv, nothing of the sort. And it is called in the terminology of tafsir, tawqifi. All these things are mawquf on how the Prophet has told us. No reasoning, no inference, no logic, no grammar, nothing of the sort. Alif Lam Ra, kitabun uhkimat ayatuhu summa fussilat min ladun hakimin khabir. Let me tell you another thing before we start the text. There is a saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, shayyabatni hudun wa akhawatuha. You know, when this surah was revealed, it appeared as if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is so much grieved, is under such a pressure, a mental pressure, a tension, that he appeared to be old. You know, gray hair appeared in his hair. So Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked him a question. What is to you? You have grown suddenly old. The reply was, shayyabatni hudun wa akhawatuha. These surahs, Hud and its sisters, who have the same style and same, you know, essence. So I have grown old because of them. Why? Because in these surahs it appears that the ajal or the time limit of Quraysh is coming to an end. And now the punishment and the chastisement is going to come down very soon. So that was the grief to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because after all, This nation was his own nation. He also was from among them. He was also from Quraysh, although they didn't believe in him, but they were their kith and kin. So, you know, he was so much, you know, grieved at this, that as if now their term is going to come to an end very soon, and the chastisement and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to start. So that was the basis of his grief. Now I have referred to the first ayah of this surah in the last hour, and that is Kitabun Uhkimat Ayatuhu Summa Fussilat Min Ladun Hakimin Khabir. This is a book, Quran, a very peculiar book. Its ayat were first made profound and strengthened and then detailed and explained from him who is Al-Hakim and Khabir, who is all wise and who is aware of everything. You know, it has two meanings. Number one, in the beginning, the ayat and surah and the surah which were revealed were very small. Ayat were also very small. Alas, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانُ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. But most profound, because there is a saying, you know, of Imam Shafi, rahimahullah, لَوْ تَدَبَّرَ النَّاسُ هَذِهِ السُّورَةَ لَوَسِعَتْهُمْ. Had people pondered over this surah only, it would have sufficed for them for all guidance that they need. Is another saying of his, quoted by Mufti Muhammad Abduhu in his tafsir. لَوْ لَمْ يُنَزَّلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ سِوَاهَا لَكَفَتِ النَّاسِ. If nothing was revealed from the Qur'an except this Suratul Asr, it would have been sufficient to guide the people. So you know the beginning surahs and ayat, they were small but very profound, saturated, so to say, with hikmah. And hikmah, ha, kaf, meem, has two meanings. Wisdom, and you know, fortified, muhkam. Muhkam is something which is fortified, which is strong enough to defend itself against any invasion. That is mustahkam. It has now gained the strength. So these ayat, in the beginning and the surahs, they were full of wisdom, very strong, very profound. But then they were detailed. Later on we are having very lengthy discourses, you know. Just like, you know, the rivulets in the mountainous region, they are narrow, but very deep. But when, you know, in the plain, their, you know, breadth increases, but depth decreases. So that is the case with the ayat which were revealed in the early days, and the ayat which were revealed in the later days. Now we had, for example, Ayatul Kursi. One ayah having more than 10 sentences in it, and that one ayah. Ayatul Birr, Laysal Birr an tuwallu wujuhakum qibala al-mashriq wal-maghrib. How much detailed one ayah. So we have long ayahs in the Madani surahs and the later Makki surahs. But in the beginning, small ayat. But they were most profound. Now you can see now, this Surah Hud must have been revealed before Surah Yunus. There is an intrinsic, you know, proof for that, and that will come very soon, we shall read it. But this point can be referred here. It contains 123 ayat, but the rukus are 10. And compare it with Yunus, it had 109 ayat, but rukus were 11. So size of the ayat in Surah Yunus is larger, bigger than the size of ayat, average size of ayat in Surah Hud. So Surah Hud was earlier revealed, and there is another internal evidence for that will come very soon, inshallah. Alif Lam Ra, Kitabul Uhkimat Ayatuhu Summa Fussilat Min Ladun Hakimin Khabir. Allah Ta'budu Illallah. The message had been the same of all the books, all the prophets, all the messengers. In one sentence, don't worship anyone except Allah. That's all. We found in the third section of Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ عُبَدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This is the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or for that matter, of the message of Quran. And this has been the essence of the message of all the prophets and messengers of Allah. But must keep before you the full meanings of ibadah. Worship, loving, obeying, serving. Four things when joined together, then it becomes ibadah. Allah ta'budu illallah innani lakum minhu nazirun wa bashir. Verily, I am for you from him a nazir, a warner, and a bashir, and a bearer of glad tidings. Wa anistaghfiru rabbakum summa tubu ilayh. And you ask a forgiveness of your Lord and turn towards him, repent towards him, relent towards him. Yumatteekum mata'an hasanan ila ajalin musamma. He'll provide you with good things, good provisions of this life. Ila ajalin musamma. But till a fixed period. Every person has a fixed time which he has to pass here. Every nation has a fixed, you know, period granted to it. وَيُوتِ كُلَّ ذِي فَضْلٍ فَضْلَهُ. And he gives to all who deserves his bounty. He gives his bounty to those only who deserve his bounty. Or whosoever has any bounty, actually it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُوتِ كُلَّ ذِي فَضْلٍ فَضْلَهُ وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ كَبِيرٍ. And if you turn your faces away, then I fear about you the chastisement of a mighty day, of a big day. إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ. To Allah is your return. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And He has power over everything. أَلَىٰ إِنَّهُمْ يَسْنُونَ صُدُورَهُمْ. Behold, they are bending or twisting their chests. لِيَسْتَقْفُوا مِنْ. So that they can hide themselves from Him. أَلَىٰ هِنَ يَسْتَغْشُونَ سِيَابَهُمْ. Behold, when they are wearing their clothing upon them, يَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. Even then he knows what they are hiding and what they are making appear. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. He knows even those things which are in the hearts or chests of the people. About this ayah, you know, there are many ways in which it has been interpreted. But because we find a hadith, you know, and it is included in the Sahih of Imam Bukhari, narrated by Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. And that we should accept as the true exegesis of this ayah. And that is, among some of the Sahaba, some of the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there were some who were overwhelmingly shy, just as Hazrat Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala. Shyness, you know, was, you know, overwhelming them. So even when they were, you know, answering the call of nature and so on, other things, and they had to be naked, they were very much ashamed of being naked. And they used to bend their chests and twist so that they can hide themselves from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is seeing us. How can we be naked? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is allaying their, you know, this fear of theirs. أَلَىٰ إِنَّهُمْ يَسْنُونَ صُدُورَهُمْ لِيَسْتَخْفُوا مِنْهُمْ. They want to hide from Allah. But even when you have your clothes you have put on, Allah knows you and see you through and through. Allah knows what you are hiding. You cannot hide and conceal anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَىٰ هِنَ يَسْتَخْشَوْنَ سِيَابَهُ. When they wrap their clothings over them, garments over them, يَعْلَبُ مَا يُسْرِنُ وَمَا يُولَنُونَ. Even at that time, he knows what they conceal and what they reveal. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Verily, he knows even those things which are hidden in the hearts. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. And there is no creature on the whole of the earth, but upon Allah rests its sustenance. This is very important for those who want to serve the deen of Allah. They shouldn't fear where from they will eat. How will they be able to support themselves and their family? The risk, you know, and the providence and provisions and sustenance of this life, that is guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. Allah takes the responsibility upon Him. Don't fear. Only you have to put your trust in Him. That is the test. وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا. Allah knows its place of abode as well as the place of repository. We heard these words in Suratul An'am perhaps, or Araf, An'am I think. And there I discussed. There are three views about it. Mustaqar is permanent abode. So mostly people think Mustaqar is Akhirah, because that is going to be the permanent abode. Mustawda is somewhere you keep something for some time. So this worldly life is Mustawda. But there is another view, although it's not held by so many, that you know, mustaqar for us is dunya, for this time, at presently. But mustauda was the wombs of the mothers. We remained there for 9 months. وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. And everything is recorded in a book which is manifest and very clear. وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. And it is He who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. And His throne was over water. Now this ayah has also intrigued, you know, so many mufassirin. What does it mean? عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. His throne was over water. Well, I dare to venture an opinion, and that is, as you know today, that before life appeared on this planet, for a very long period, you know, rains were falling for thousands of years altogether, continuously. Because when this earth, you know, became cold, it shrunk. When it shrunk, there were mountains, there were, you know, up and downs, you know. There were low regions and high regions. Then, you know, when rain came, now there were the oceans. So at that time, it was all ocean, all water. So actually, this world, for this world, you know, the government of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so to say, that of this universal government, it was on water. But I can't say that this is actually what is meant by these words here. But this is what, you know, it has come to my mind. وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Then, you know, life began, and then, you know, humans and mankind were created. And what for created? لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. So that He may try you and test you, which one of you is better in his deeds. This is the same ayah as we find in Surah Al-Mulk, خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He created life and death, and so that this worldly life becomes for you a period of testing. In the same way, لَيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He has created you here in this world. This worldly life is meant to be a period of testing. قُلْ زُمِ هَسْتِي سَتُو عُبْرَاهِمَانِ اِنْدَي حَبَابِ اِسْ زِيَانْ خَانَي مِنْ تَيْرَا اِمْتِحَانْ هَيْ زِندَگِي. This life is actually a period of testing and trial. وَلَئِنْ قُلْتَ إِنَّكُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِ الْمَوْتِ. And if you say, you will be resurrected and raised after your death. لَيَقُولَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. These unbelievers will surely say, it is nothing but a magic or a sorcery. وَإِلَا أَخَّرْنَا عَنُهُ الْعَذَابَ إِلَىٰ أُمَّةٍ مَعْدُودَةٍ. And if we postpone and delay for them the chastisement for a time which is already fixed, maduda, it is already fixed. لَيَقُولُنَّ مَا يَحْبِسُهُ. They will surely say, what is preventing it to come? They were making haste. Why don't you bring that chastisement? We have been hearing, you know, from you for 10 long years that azab will come and chastisement and torment will come. But what is holding it back? مَا يَحَبِسُ. أَلَا يَوْمَ تَيَعْتِهِمْ لَيْسَ مَصْرُوفًا عَنْهُمْ. Behold, when it will come to them, it will not be able to be turned away from them. وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. And they will be encircled by that on which they were mocking, and about which they were joking. وَلَيْنَ رَقْنَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنَّا رَحْمَةً ثُمَّ نَزَعْنَاهَا مِنْهُ إِنَّهُ لَيَوْثٌ كَفُورٌ. Now these two conditions, extreme conditions for man, for common men, usually is the case with men. And if we make a man taste from our mercy, we have given him wealth and health and everything, so our mercy is there, and he's tasting life and all the good things of life. ثُمَّ نَزَعْنَا مِنْ. And then we withdraw these things from him. إِنَّهُ لَيَوْسٌ كَفُورٌ. He becomes absolutely disappointed, despaired, and ungrateful. He says, I saw never any good thing in life. Oh, Allah has never given me anything. He became so ungrateful. وَلَيْنَ ذَقْنَاهُ نَعْمَاءَ بَعْضَ ذَرَّا وَسَّتْهُ. And if we give him the taste of our mercy and our, you know, blessings, after, you know, some hurting had come to him, something which was unpleasant to لَيَقُولَنَّ ذَهَبَ السَّيِّئَاتُ عَنِّي. And then he will say, definitely say, well, all evils have gone from me. إِنَّهُ لَفَرِحٌ فَخُورٌ. Then he becomes overjoyed, farah. I told you this word is used in the Quran not in a good sense. Farah, overjoyed. And fakhur, boastful. You know, because everything which is coming to us in this world is for testing. If something unpleasant, it is also for testing, whether we persevere or not. We show patience or not. If something good has come, whether we are grateful or not, we become overjoyed, you know, and that also shows, you know, the shallowness of our personality. So actually, we should have something in between, in all the cases. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. But this is not the case of those who have patience. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Except those who have patience and perseverance, and they could do good deeds. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. And for them, there will be the forgiving, pardoning, and a very great reward. فَلَعَلَّكَ تَارِكُمْ بَعْضَ مَنْ يُوحَىٰ إِلَيْكَ وَضَائِقٌ بِهِ صَدْرُكَ أَنْ يَقُولُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ كَنْزٌ أَوْ جَاءَ مَعَهُ مَلَكٌ. So perhaps or perchance you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are going to leave some of what has been sent down to you, revealed to you. وَضَائِقٌ بِهِ صَدْرُكَ. And your chest is shrinking on it. أَنْ يَقُولُوا, that they are saying, لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ كَنْزٌ. Why has not been a treasure sent down on him? He says, I am the representative of Allah, the master of all the worlds. Wouldn't he give him a treasure? Wealth? We saw him all the life toiling in his childhood, even his, you know, early adolescence. He was working as a laborer. Then he was working as a merchant. And he claims to be the representative of Allah, the ambassador of Allah on earth. So how come? Wouldn't Allah give him the wealth and riches? أَوْ جَاءَ مَعَهُ مَلَكٌ. And if he is really a messenger of Allah, so angels could have been accompanying him, you know, shouting to people, oh, this is messenger of Allah, you must believe in him. وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَكِيلٌ. Allah is a guardian over everything. Now because these things were coming to him repeatedly and repeatedly and repeatedly, people were saying these things, you know, and you know, years had passed after years. So maybe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also felt somewhat, you know, grieved at it. And we find it. إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ يَزِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. But they are saying, you know, your chest shrinks over it due to grief and sorrow. So perhaps, but I don't think, you know, this is directed towards those people who are pressurizing him. You are pressurizing him so that he should give up some of those things which have been revealed to him. But you know, apparently it is directed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but actually it is meant for those who are pressurizing him. فَلَعَلَّكَ تَارِكُمْ بَعْضَ مَا يُحَىٰ إِلَيْكَ وَضَائِقٌ بِهِ صَدْرُكَ أَنْ يَقُولُوا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ كَنْزٌ أَوْ جَاءَ مَعَهُ مَلَكٌ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ نَذِيرٌ. O Muhammad, you are nothing but a warner. وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَكِيلٌ. It's Allah who is the guardian over everything. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ. Are they saying that he has composed it? He has forged it? He has, you know, concocted all this? قُلْ فَاتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ. This is the intrinsic proof and evidence that this surah was revealed before Surah Yunus. Because, you know, this argument, you know, it started from the whole of Quran. We find in Surah to Bani Israel, قُلْ لَيْنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ يَاتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَاتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Tell them, if all humans, all jinns could join together to compose a book like this Quran, they will not be able to compose it, although they might help each other. So here, a full book that was asked, that if you can do, you also compose a full book. But then, بَرْسَبِيلَ تَنَزُّلْ, it is called, you know. If you couldn't do that, okay. Then you compose 10 surahs, okay. Not this whole of book, 10 surahs. And when they couldn't meet this challenge, okay. Now you come forth with one surah. So it's gradual. Whole of Quran, Surah Bani Israel. Here, 10 surah. 10 surahs. Fatu bi ashri suwarin mislihi. You also bring forth 10 surahs like this. Muftarayatin, which may be composed by men and forged by humans. Wadu man istata'tum min dunillah. And you call whomsoever you can, except Allah. In kuntum sadiqeen, if you are true. Failam yastajibu lakum. But then if they don't, you know, accept your challenge, if they don't reply to your request, فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ بِعِلْمِ اللَّهِ. Now you must know that it has been sent down with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ilaha illahu, and there's no God except He. فَعْلَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. So now are you ready to submit? When you couldn't meet the challenge, when you couldn't, and your false gods didn't reply you, they couldn't help you, you could call to them, okay? Send us some, you know, some jinn who can compose, you know, surahs like Quran. Your false gods have failed you. You are unable to accept the challenge. So you must be ready now to submit and surrender. فَعَلَنْتُ مُسْلِمُونَ. مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ حَيَاتَ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتَهَا نُوَفِّ إِلَيْهِمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فِيهَا وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يُبْخَسُونَ. Whosoever intends to have the enjoyment of this life of this world, and its adornment. نُوَفِّ إِلَيْهِمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. We pay them in full for their deeds. وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يُبْخَسُونَ. And they shall not be made to suffer anything. No diminution will be done. If somebody has chosen this world, is working hard day and night, okay, we shall give him the wealth of this life, the comforts of this life. After all, he's working hard day and night. He's sweating, you know, like anything. So he must be given something from this world. نُوَفِّهِ. And we give them full, pay them in full. إِلَيْهِمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. All their deeds. فِيهَا. In this world. وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يُبْخَسُونَ. And nothing, they will be deprived of nothing of their labor. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا النَّارِ. But for them, they are those, for them there will be nothing in the hereafter except fire. وَحَبِتَ مَا صَنَعُوا. And whatsoever they had produced in this world will go in vain, because they never intended to have anything in Akhirah. Even if they were doing some good deeds, they wanted, you know, that people should, you know, praise them, that they are very philanthropist type of person, they are very good persons. So actually, if even they were doing apparently good deeds, they didn't want the recompense or the reward of Akhirah. They wanted all the reward in this world, and we have given it. So now, in the Akhirah, they don't have anything to get except Naar. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا النَّارُ وَحَبِطَ مَا صَنَعُوا فِيهَا وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Whatever good deeds they were doing, they were also false and hollow, without any basis. Now comes a very important ayah of this surah, and this is going to be the key word and key theme of this surah. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ عَلَىٰ بَيِّنَةٍ مِّنْ رَبِهِ وَيَتْلُوهُ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْهُ. So, the person who was already on a self-evident truth from his Lord, and then follows him a witness from him. What does it mean? As I told you, human nature, it contains all the iman and all the facts in potential. Potentially, it is there. Love of God is there. The soul which was breathed into us. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. This ruh, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it has all the things, just like, you know, a seed contains the whole of plant. Where from does the plant come? From that seed. Potentially the whole plant, the whole tree is present in that nut or seed. In the same way, in human nature, there is bayyana. If the nature is not perverted, if it is a healthy nature, pure human nature, it is bayyana within you. Now when the revelation comes, it is a witness. It testifies that whatever you have in your heart is correct. دیکھنا تقریر کی لذت کے جو اس نے کہا میں نے یہ جانا کہ گویا یہی میرے دل میں ہے. And this is what Hafiz ibn Qayyim rahimahullah has said in one of his articles, that there are some people who will read Quran. They feel that they are not reading Quran from the Mushaf, from this book. They feel this Quran is written on their hearts, and they are reading it from there. Because there is complete harmony between the human nature and what Quran is saying. So actually this Quran testifies that whatever human nature is saying is correct. You may say that human nature and soul testifies that whatever Quran is saying is correct. So this is a mutual testimony, mutual harmony between the two. So if there was a person who had a pure nature, now just imagine Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, pure of nature, tender-hearted, a muttaqi person, God-fearing person, and you know he was very kind to people, and he was of the sound intellect. He never worshipped any idols, even before he started coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a muwahid from the very beginning. So he is the person, he was the person. In the same way, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was such a person. But I am not mentioning Muhammad because he was a prophet. And prophet is by birth a prophet. So I am mentioning Hazrat Abu Bakr or Hazrat Uthman ibn Maz'un. There was another person who died before the revelation started coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was Zaid. His son, you know, Sa'id ibn Zaid is one of the 10 topmost Sahaba. Ashra'i Mubashara. Sa'id ibn Zaid, who was the brother-in-law of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Imam came to Sa'id ibn Zaid and his wife Fatima bint Khattab before it came to Umar ibn Khattab. Rather, it came to Umar ibn Khattab through them. And actually, why? Because Sa'id was son of Zaid. And Zaid was also one of such persons, a very kind-hearted, very pure-natured person, who used to say, holding, you know, the curtains of Kaaba, "Oh Allah, I want to worship you and you alone, but I don't know how to worship you." Now, had the revelation to Muhammad started in his lifetime, he would have been the Siddiq, one of the Siddiqs. So this is the nature, human nature, the testimony. Quran testifies to the human nature. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ عَلَىٰ بَيِّنَةٍ مِنْ رَبَيْهِ وَيَتْلُوهُ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْهُ. Now when revelation is coming, it is actually witness that whatever you have in your, the self-evident truth that you have in your souls, actually it is correct. And that is how we can understand when revelation came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How did he recognize it is revelation? How did he recognize that this is an angel? Not an evil spirit. He could have any thought, doubt. Maybe he's Satan. Maybe he's some jinn. He has come to, you know, lead me astray. But no. His nature recognized. So man is not blind by nature. He has that, you know, the sight also. And, you know, the intellect also, the soul of man. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ عَلَىٰ بَيِّنَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَيَتْلُوهُ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْهُ وَمِنْ قَبْلِهِ كِتَابُ مُوسَىٰ. And this Qur'an has come as a witness now. And before this Qur'an, there was the book of Moses, Imamam وَرَحْمَةٌ. This was also guidance and mercy. أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Such people will come to believe in this book because they are pure of nature. They will have no difficulty in recognizing the truth of this book and the truthfulness of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ مِنَ الْأَحْزَابِ. And whosoever rejects it from among all the groups and factions, because there were the idolaters, there were the Jews and Christians, مِنَ الْأَحْزَابِ فَالنَّارُ مَعِدُهُ. So fire is the place of their promise. فَلَا تَكُ فِي مِرْيَةٍ مِّنْهُ. And you should not be in any doubt about that. إِنَّهُ الْحَقُّ بِرَبِّكَ. And this is the truth from your Lord. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But you know, most of the people are not going to believe. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. And who is more evildoer than the person who concocts or forges something and then attributes it to Allah? This is the biggest crime. This is the biggest lie. If I am not a prophet and I say I am a prophet, this is the biggest lie. You are lying on Allah. And some people is lying something about humans, about men. But he is, you know, attributing that thing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a false thing. So this is the biggest crime. Ulaika yu'raduna ala rabbihim. They will be presented before their Lord, whosoever does this crime. وَيَقُولُ الْأَشْهَادُ هَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. And then the witnesses will say, these are the people who forged this and they attributed it to their Lord. عَلَىٰ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And behold, the curse of Allah will be on such evil doers. Now what is the essence of this ayah? Do you or can you imagine for even a single moment that Muhammad can do it? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have known him. He has lived with you for 40 years. And if it is being revealed in the 10th year after the beginning of Wahi, for 50 years you know him. Did he ever tell a lie? If he didn't tell a lie, in the matters of this world, small disputes, if he didn't attribute any false thing to any human, how could you expect that he would attribute something false to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because this is the biggest crime. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أُولَٰئِكَ يُعْرَضُونَ عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ وَيَقُولُ الْأَشْهَادُ هَٰؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ عَلَىٰ لَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ الَّذِينَ يَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those zalimeen, those evildoers who are obstructing people, who are holding back themselves from the path of Allah and obstructing others, preventing others from going towards the path of Allah. I told you, sadda yasuddo has both the meanings. Hold back yourself and you prevent others. They want to find in it crookedness. فَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ. And the real cause is that they don't believe in the hereafter. That is actually the root cause of all their ills. أُولَٰئِكَ لَمْ يَكُونُوا مُعْجِزِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. These people are not going to be able to frustrate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, defeat him in the land, on the earth. وَمَا كَانَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ أَوْلِيَاءَ. And there will not be for them, besides Allah, any protectors. يُضَافُ لَهُمُ الْعَذَابِ. The chastisement will be doubled for them. مَا كَانُوا يَسْتَطِعُونَ السَّمْعَ وَمَا كَانُوا يُبْصِرُونَ. They were not able to hear and they were not seeing. Because the real human being within them had died. Their souls had died. Now they were like, you know, just moving graves. Nothing of that sort. Moving mausoleums. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَضَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. They are the people who have ruined themselves, who have put themselves in the loss. وَضَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. And whatever they are concocting and whatever they are forging, that these are going to help us and they will be our intercessors, they will all disappear and vanish. لَا جَرَمَ. There is no doubt أَنَّهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ هُمُ الْأَخْسَرُونَ. That in the hereafter they will be the greatest in losing. The biggest losers, the greatest losers will be them. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَأَخْبَتُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. As for those who believe and do good deeds, and they are humble to their Lords, humble before their Rabb, أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. They are the people of garden, هُمْ فِيَا خَالِدُونَ, and they will dwell in it forever. مَثَلُ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ كَالْعَمَى وَالْأَصَمِّ وَالْبَصِيرِ وَالسَّمِيعِ. Now these two groups, the similitude of these two groups is like the similitude of those who are blind and deaf. And on the other hand, there are people who are seeing and hearing. Those who believe, they are the people who are seeing and hearing. Those who are rejecting and denying and belying this truth, they are like the deaf and the dumb, blind and deaf. هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَانِ مَسَلًا. Are they equal? Are they similar? In this similitude? أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. So don't you get reminded and admonished. Now comes, you know, the story of Nuh. And I told you, two sections of this surah, 25 ayat are devoted to the story of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Although, you know, it has been repeated many a time, but this is the longest discourse. We have another surah, complete surah, in the 28th part, Suratul Nuh. It also has 28 ayat. It is absolutely and exclusively devoted to the history of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. But the, you know, counterpart, you can say, is this place in the Quran, where, you know, this has been discussed in detail. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. And we had sent Nuh to his nation. Now, not nation, whole of the nation. Nation as a whole. إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. And he said, I am for you a clear warner. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And you know, the message is that you don't worship anything, anyone except Allah. إِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ أَلِيمٍ. I fear on you the chastisement of a very big day, very mighty day. فَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. So replied the chiefs of his nation who had disbelieved him. مَا نَرَاكَ إِلَّا بَشْرًا مِثْلَنَا. We don't see you except you are also a human being, you are also mortal like us. وَمَا نَرَاكَ اتَّبَعَكَ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَرَاذِلُنَا بَادِيَ الرَّايِ. And we don't see that anybody had followed you except those who are meanest. Apparently, most apparently the meanest of our slaves, our servants. Some of those have gathered around you. No, none of the noble, the nobility, none of the aristocracy, none of the wealthy people. Nobody has, you know, accepted your dawah and accepted you as the messenger of Allah, except, you know, some people, you know, who belong to the lowest status of our society. وَمَا نَرَاكَ إِلَّا تَبَعَكَ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ وَرَادُلُنَا بَعْدِيَ الرَّائِ. Most apparently, we can see that they belong to the lowest strata of our society. وَمَا نَرَا لَكُمْ عَلَيْنَا مِنْ فَضْلٍ. And we don't see that there is any superiority in you or them over us. If this was the truth which you are presenting, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should have made you superior to us in wealth also, in position also, in, you know, in this hierarchy of the tribe also. But we don't find. You are not from among the chiefs, you are not from among the wealthiest people of the tribe. And in the same way, only these people, you know, the poor, they people are gathering around you. Bal nazunnukum kazibin. Oh, we think that you are telling a lie. You are an imposter. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَوَلَىٰ بَيِّنَةً مِّن رَبِّي. Now this is the same thing. I told you this is going to be the central idea. He said, oh my nation, oh my people, have you considered if I was on bayyana from my Rabb? You know, you have been seeing me. The nature that I had, that I was bestowed upon by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my character, you have been seeing me all along. If I was on a self-evident light from my rod, وَآتَانِ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِهِ, and then he gave me the mercy from his treasures. That is wahi. This has come to me later. For 40 years there was no wahi to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was on the bayyana from his Lord, right from his birth. His character, his personality, you know, was a shining light. But you know, wahi was not coming. But then wahi came. Light added unto light. Noorun ala noor. Just as we have in Surah An-Noor. Noorun ala noor. The nature was a noor itself. And then the wahi, noor of wahi has also come. So noor has been added to noor. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَلَىٰ بَيِّنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي وَآتَانِي رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِهِ فَأُمِّيَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ. And this has been obscured from you. You are not able to see it. So can we compel you to accept it? If you are not liking it, if you are abhorring it, we cannot compel you to accept it. And my people, just look and think. I have never asked you for any money. I have never asked you for any wealth. I don't ask you for any ajr. In ajri illa Allah, my reward, my salary, my remuneration, everything rests with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَنَا بِطَارِدِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And I am not going to drive away those who have come to believe. Whether they are from your servants, whether they are from your slaves, whether do you feel that they are the mean people, they are the menials and so on, whatever you may like to say. مَا أَنَا بِطَارِدِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. I am not going to drive them away. إِنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا رَبِّهِمْ. They will be meeting their Lord. وَلَاكِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ قَوْمًا تَجْهَلُونَ But I do see that you are in ignorance. You are not seeing the truth. You are ignorant. وَيَا قَوْمِ مَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ And my people just think, who will save me? Who will be able to save me? Who will be able to help me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I interrupt them if I drive them away. Because they are poor, I drive them away. I push them away from me. وَيَا قَوْمِ مَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ تَرَبْتُهُمْ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ Do you not get reminded, admonition? وَلَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنْدِي خَزَائِنَ The same wording which appeared regarding Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَلَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنْدِي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ I have never claimed, I don't claim that I possess the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا عَلَمُ الْغَيْبِ And I clearly state that I don't know the unseen. وَلَا أَقُولُ إِنِّي مَلَكٌ Nor do I say that I am an angel. I've never claimed to be an angel. وَلَا أَقُولُ لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَدْرِي أَعْيُنُكُمْ لَنْ يُوتِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا Nor I can say that the people, your eyes are looking down upon them, these people, you are hating them, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give them the goods of hereafter, you know. فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً You are seeing them to be mean or low, but maybe they are high in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, I can't say. Allahu a'lamu bima anfusihim. Allah very well knows. He is aware of what is there in their souls. Inni idhan la min al-zalimin. If I drive them away, well, I would become one of the evildoers. Qalu ya Nuh qad jadaltana fa aksarta jidalana. They said, oh Nuh, You have disputed with us. You have argued with us. And you have gained a lot in this dispute. You have made a lot of dispute. It can be translated in both ways. You have made a lot of dispute and argument. Now we are fed up with this argument. فَاتِنَا بِمَا تَعِدُنَا إِن كُنْتَ مِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ Now if you are true, now bring to us what you are threatening us. Bring the azab of Allah, call on Allah, He should send the azab on us, the chastisement or the torment about which we have been talking so long. Now let it be, let it happen. قَالَ إِنَّمَا يَعْتِيكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ إِنْشَاءَ He replied, Allah will bring it to you, on you, if He so desires. وَمَانْتُمْ بِمُوْجِزِينَ And when it comes, You will not be able to defeat. You will not be able to protect yourself from that chastisement. You will not be able to escape it. وَلَا يَنْفَعُكُمْ نُصْحِي إِنْ أَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَنْصَحَ لَكُمْ And I know that my sincere counseling and advice will be of no avail to you, even if I sincerely want for you that you be saved. وَلَا يَنْفَعُكُمْ نُصْحِي إِنْ أَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَنْصَحَ لَكُمْ إِنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يُغْوِيَكُمْ If Allah has decided that he has to lead you astray. He has put a seal on your fate. He has set the seals on your heart that I can't do it. Huwa Rabbukum, He is your Lord. Wa ilayhi turja'un, and to Him you will be returned. Am yakulun aftara? Are they saying that He has concocted these things? Now here He means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the midst of this discourse, discussing the events of Hazrat Nuh, And what was going on between him and his people? Now, between them, there is reference to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Am yaqulun aftara? Now, these things which we are revealing to you, O Muhammad, do they say that you have forged them? Qul in iftaraytuhu fa'alayya ijrami. Say to them, if I have concocted these things, forged these things, these ayat, fa'alayya ijrami, so on me will be my guilt. My crime will be on me. وَأَنَا بَرِيُّمْ مِمَّا تُجْرِمُونَ But likewise, I am absolutely unanswerable for your guilts, what you are doing. If what I am saying is correct, it is from Allah and you are rejecting. Well, you will be repaid, you will be rewarded, you will be recompensed. If, for the sake of argument, if I am doing this thing wrong, then I will have to face the consequences. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَىٰ نُوحٍ And it was revealed to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ That now nobody else is going to come to believe from your people except those who have already believed. A full stop has been put now. أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ فَلَا تَبْتَئِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. So don't be in distress. Now don't be disappointed. Don't be in agony on what they have been doing. وَصْنَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِعَيُنِنَا وَوَحْيَنَا. And now construct the ark according to بِعَيُنِنَا, before our eyes. We will be watching. We will be giving instructions. وَوَحْيَنَا. And our wahi will be coming. How long, how broad, how much, you know, deep, what, how to build it. Continuous instructions coming. وَصْنَعِ الْفُلْكَ بِعَيُنِنَا. In our eyes, we are seeing, we are watching. وَوَحْيَنَا. And our instructions coming to you through revelations. وَلَا تُخَاطِبْنِي فِي الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. And now, don't address me, never address me regarding these people who have transgressed, who have rejected. إِنَّهُمْ مُغْرَقُونَ. All of them are going to be drowned. Now it shouldn't happen that, you know, your brotherly feelings for your people, they are aroused in your heart and then you say, oh Allah, pardon them. Now, no. If this has happened, it has been decreed. Now don't address me regarding these people. Although they might be your kith and kin, your relatives, maybe your own son, maybe your own wife. But now you cannot address me and you cannot call upon me to have any mercy on them. وَيَصْنَعُ الْفُلْكَ. And he was constructing the ark. كُلَّمَا مَرَّ عَلَيْهِ مَلَوْ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ سَخِرُوا مِنْهُ. Whenever the chiefs from his nation, from his people, passed by him, they joked, scoffed on him. What is he doing? Now, you know, he has gone mad, absolutely mad. We doubted from the very beginning that he is crazy. Now, he is absolutely mad. On in this region, far away from any ocean, far away from any sea, far away from any big river, and he is constructing such a big ark, such a big boat. Where will he float it? Now, no doubt that he has gone crazy. وَيَسْنَعُ الْفُلْكَ وَكُلَّمَا مَرَّ عَلَيْهِ مَلَوْ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ سَخِرُوا مِنْهُ قَالَ إِنْ تَسْخِرُوا مِنَّا فَإِنَّا نَسْخَرُ مِنْكُمْ. He replied, now see the bitterness in the words of Nuh. If you are joking on us and scoffing on us today, a time will come, we will be scoffing on you. كَمَا تَسْخَرُونَ. As you are scoffing on us. فَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ يَأْتِيهِ عَذَابٌ يُخْزِيهِ. And very soon you will know to whom comes the torment and the chastisement which will humiliate him. وَيَحِلُّ عَلَيْهِ عَذَابٌ مُقِيمٌ. And a lasting chastisement and torment will come upon them. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا وَفَارَ التَّنُّورِ. Thus it was, it happened, kept on happening, until our command came. حَتَّى جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا وَفَارَ التَّنُّورِ. And the oven boiled out. First of all, a big tannur, a big oven, you know, a very gushing water started coming from that. And at other places, we know that a very strong rain started coming from the skies, and there were from everywhere, you know, the earth was, you know, there were fissures which appeared in the earth, and from that water was gushing out. And let me tell you, H.G. Wells has given an explanation, a physical explanation. He has written it in his, but I don't now fully remember, he has written two books on the world history, a short history of the world and a concise history of the world. In which of them, I'm not sure, but in one of them he has written that this, you know, big flood came because the level of this area at that time, this region, was lower than the level of the ocean. And along the coast of the Mediterranean, there was a high ridge. And they say it is the case in Karachi also. Some areas of Karachi are lower than the level of the ocean, level of the sea. But because along the coast, there is a ridge, stony ridge. So that protects Karachi. Maybe at some time, you know, there is some you know, crack in that ridge and water then gushes. If the sea level is higher than that ground, you know, it will come like anything. And it can be from one spot. In a big, you know, just as Karbala Dam, for example, God forbid, even if there is a crack at one place, what will happen? It will bring havoc. So his, you know, explanation is that the level of this land was lower at that time than the surface of the Mediterranean Sea. And along the coast of the Mediterranean Sea, there was a ridge, mountainous ridge, which was holding the ocean. Then there was some, you know, leaking. And that place, Farat and Nur, as Quran said, maybe it's just possible, it's just an explanation. And then, you know, the ocean, whole the water of ocean, you know, gushed into this area. And there was a flood over a very vast area. And it appears from the Quran that the progeny of Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam, was limited to this region till that time. So that when, you know, they were drowned, so actually the whole progeny of Adam, alayhi salam, was finished, except the people who were among Hazrat, who were with Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam in his ark. Wallahu alam. Wa farat tanur qulna hamil fiha min kulli zawjain isnain. And we said, embark in it a pair from every kind. Wa ahlaka, and your own family. Illa man sabaqa alayhi al-qawl. Except from your family, on whom the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already gone. Waman aman, and all those who have come to believe with you. So a pair from all kinds of animals and birds and beasts and so on. Min kulli zawjain isnayn. Number two, your own family, except from your own family even, about whom the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already come. And as we know, it was number one of his wives, and number two, one of his sons. They were from his family. Because we find it in Surah At-Tahrim, mention of wife of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam and wife of Hazrat Lut alayhi salam, that they were, you know, unbelievers, they were with the kuffar, and they were, you know, punished along with those who were punished. And you will find here the story of one of his sons. وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. And people didn't believe in him except only a very few. They say they were 72. I feel not even 72. Only three of his sons, their wives, maybe one or two wives of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam himself, and a few servants. And after him, you know, the progeny of humans started only from the three sons of Hazrat Nuh. Hazrat Ham, Hazrat Sam, Hazrat Yafis. وَقَالَ ارْكَبُوا فِيهَا بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَجْرِهَا وَمُرْسَاهَا. And he said, now embark in it. With Allah's name shall be its running, its floating, and its mooring. إِنَّ رَبِّي لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Verily my Lord, my Rabb, is forgiving and merciful. وَهِيَ تَجْرِي بِهِمْ فِي مَوْجٍ كَالْجِبَالِ. And it was moving with them amid waves like mountains. وَنَادَى نُوحٌ ابْنَهُ. And Nuh called out to his son. وَكَانَ فِي مَعْدِلٍ. And he was standing aloof. He had not embarked that ship, that ark. He was standing aloof. يَا بُنَيَّ ارْكَبْ مَعَنَا. Oh my son, oh my dear son, you also embark with us. وَلَا تَكُنْ مَعَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Don't be with those who are disbelievers. قَالَ سَعَوِي إِلَى جَبَلٍ يَعْصِمُنِي مِنَ الْمَاءِ. He said, no, no harm. Very soon I will reach that mountain. I'll, you know, climb that mountain. It will save me, protect me from the water. قَالَ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِيمٌ. He said, no protection today, none to protect, except min amrillah, from the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No protection, no protector, illa man rahim, except whom he shows mercy. Only his mercy can rescue you, nothing else. Wahala bainahum al-mawj, and a wave intervened between them. Fakana min al-mughraqeen, and he became one of those who were drowned. وَقِيلَ يَا عَرْضُ ابْلَعِي مَاءَكِ. And it was said, O earth, you swallow back your water. فَيَا سَمَاءُ اقْلَعِي. And O sky, O heaven, with all your water. وَغِيدَ الْمَاءَ and water subsided. وَقُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ and the whole matter was settled and decided. وَاسْتَوَتْ عَلَى الْجُودِي and the ark stayed, came to a rest on Judi. This Judi is a peak among the Ararat range of mountains. And this is an area which is absolutely in between, adjoiningly, where these three countries are meeting. Turkey, Russia, Armenia. And this is a very difficult place to go, you know, to reach the top. So whenever, you know, Muslims have some authority and they can do it and they have the means, they should send this expedition. Because Quran says in many places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept it. And it will appear and people will know that this is the Ark of Noah, alayhi salatu wassalam. وَقِيلَ بَعْضًا لِلْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ It was said and proclaimed, done away with the evil doing people. They have been finished. بَعْضًا لِلْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ فَنَادَى نُوحٌ رَبَّهُ And now Nuh called out to his Lord. فَقَالَ رَبِّي إِنَّ ابْنِي مِنْ أَهْلِي And he said, Oh my Lord, my son was from amongst my family. إِنَّ وَعْدَكَ الْحَقِّ And your promise is true. You promised you will save my family. وَأَنْتَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ And you are the best judge of all the judges. Now the way, it's a complaint. But the way how this complaint is being presented to the Lord. فَنَادَ أَنُوَ رَبَّهُ قَالَ رَبِّ إِنَّ ابْنِي مِنْ أَهْلِي وَإِنَّ وَعْدَكَ الْحَقِّ وَأَنْتَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ He couldn't say, Why my son was destroyed and drowned? You had promised me that my family will remain safe. قَالَ يَا نُوحُ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ This very important place of Quran. Even, you know, a bondsman like Nuh, having served Allah for nearly 1,000 years, but still he is a bondsman. الرَّبُّ رَبٌّ وَإِنْ تَنَزَّلْ وَالْعَبْدُ عَبْدٌ وَإِنْ تَرَقَّى Bondsman remains a bondsman. He might ascend to the seventh heaven, as Muhammad ascended, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the night of ascension. And the Lord remains the Lord, although he may come down to the lowest heaven. The difference of Lord and bondsman remains as such. Just look, 1,000 years, hardest labor, calling people, bearing all the hardships, people laughing, mocking at him. But here, a slight, you know, you may say, an appeal, a request, a humble request. But it had an, you know, a sort of protest. وَنَادَى نُوحُ رَبَّهُ فَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنَّ ابْنِي مِنْ أَهْلِي وَإِنَّ وَعْدَكَ الْحَقِّ وَأَنْتَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ In the most careful words, but it contains something like a, what would you say, protest. قَالَ يَا نُوحُ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٍ فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ إِنِّي أَعِذُكَ أَنْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ Look to the harshness of the words. The same words appeared for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Suratul An'am. Don't be from among jahileen. If you can, فَإِنْ كَانَ كَبْرُ عَلَيْكَ عِرَاضُهُمْ فَإِنْ اسْتَطَعْتَ أَنْ تَبْتَغِيَ نَفَقًا فِي الْأَرْضِ أَوْ سُلَّمًا فِي الْأَرْضِ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَتَأْتِيَهُمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ If, you know, the matter has become unbearable for you, if you can, you know, if you can dig a tunnel in the land, or you can have a ladder into the sky and bring them a miracle, go and have it. Who is being addressed here? إِنْ كَانَ كَبْرُكَ عَلَيْكَ إِرَاضُهُ فَنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ أَنْ تَبْتَغِيَ نَفَقًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَسُلَّمًا فِي السَّمَاءِ فَتَأْتِيَهُمْ بِآيَةٍ The same. قَالَ يَا نُوحُ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ He replied, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied, He is not from your family. إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٌ He is of unrighteous deeds. فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ. Don't ask me about which you don't have the knowledge. The Ahl-e Tashayyu interpret this ayah in a particular sense. And that is that this son of Hazrat Nuh, his name was Yam or Kin'an, two names have been mentioned. Yam, and you know on the same meter, Sam, Ham, Yam. But another name mentioned is Kin'an. But he was not his son actually. His wife about whom Surah Tahreem is telling, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا امْرَأَةَ نُوحٍ وَامْرَأَةَ لُوطٍ كَانَتَا تَحْتَ عَبْدَيْنِ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا صَالِحَيْنِ فَخَانَتَاهُمَا فَلَمْ يُغْنِيَا عَنْهُمَا مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا فَقِيلَ ادْخُلَا النَّارَ مَعَ الدَّاخِلِينَ خِيَانَة. So they were corrupt. That's the interpretation that they give. So actually, this son of Nuh was a bastard, according to their interpretation of this ayah and the ayah of Suratul Tahreem. But the Ahl-e Sunnah don't accept it. They don't accept that, you know, an unfaithful wife, you know, corrupt. Corrupt in that sense, you know, committing adultery cannot be in the house of a Nabi of Allah, a Prophet of Allah. So I only just mentioned it. إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٍ فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Don't ask me for which you have no knowledge. إِنِّي أَعِذُكَ أَن تَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. I admonish you, lest you should become one of the ignorants. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ أَن أَسْأَلَكَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Immediately, Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam replied, O my Lord, I take refuge in Thee, lest I should ask from You about which I have no knowledge. وَإِلَّا تَغْفِرْ لِي وَتَرْحَمْنِي أَكُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And if You don't forgive me and You don't show mercy to me, I will become one of the losers. The same verse which Hazrat Adam Hawa, they uttered, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنْفُسَنَا وَإِنْ لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. We read it in Surah Al-A'raf. قِيلَ يَا نُوحُ بِسَلَامٍ مِنَّا وَبَرَكَاتٍ عَلَيْكَ. It was said and proclaimed. قِيلَ. It was said. Some angel might have proclaimed. يَا نُوحُ بِسَلَامٍ مِنَّا. O Nuh, now you get down from this ark with peace from us. Salam minna wa barakatin, and blessings from us. Alayka, on you, wa ala umamin mimman ma'ak, and all the nations and communities who will emerge from those who are with you in the ark. These words are very important. Umamin mimman ma'ak, the communities and nations, the progenies of those who are with you in the ark. وَأُمَمٌ سَنُمَكِّعُهُمْ. And there are going to be nations whom we shall give some worldly things, some provisions of this world. ثُمَّ يَمَسُّهُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And then a very painful torment is going to come to them. Now this refers to Aad. They were also from the progeny of Hazrat Islam alayhi salatu wasalam. Then again to Samud, he was also from the progeny of, from Ad, and so on. And even the Chaldean Empire, you know, that was in Iraq, that was also from Sam. So all these, you know, prophets who are mentioned in Quran, they are actually all progeny of Sam, Semitic races. Whether they are, you know, the Jews, or they are the Arabs, they were the Chaldeans, all these Phoenicians, etc., etc. All people who lived in Syria, in Iraq, in the Arabian Peninsula, all these people. And from there actually, at you know, different times, people came out and invaded. At the time of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam, the king in Egypt was from this very Arabian Peninsula. He was not Fir'aun. That is why in the Surah Yusuf, we don't find the word Fir'aun. Malik, Qal al-Malik. They were actually the Hyksos kings, they call, in the history of Egypt. This was not a dynasty of Fir'aina, but it was another dynasty of a people who had come from the Arabian Peninsula, invaded Egypt, and they had established their rule over there. So this was, so to say, a reservoir of human potential. وَأُمَمٌ سَنُمَتِّعُهُمْ ثُمَّ يَمَسُّهُمْ مِنَّا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ تِلْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهَا إِلَيْكَ. This is the concluding ayah of this discourse. These are from the news of the unseen, which we are revealing to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَا كُنْتَ تَعْلَمُهَا أَنْتَ وَلَا قَوْمُكَ. You didn't know them, neither you yourself nor your nation. People of Ad were known to these Arabs. People of Hud, Ad, because they dwelt in the peninsula, in the southern part of the peninsula, which is the worst type of deserts today. Worst desert in the world. And Samud, this nation was also inhabiting the Arabian Peninsula, the northern, western, corner of Arabian Peninsula, just near the Gulf of Aqaba. So these people, then, along the right or the eastern coast of Aqaba, they were the people who were, to whom was sent Hazrat Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam. Then, round the coast of the Dead Sea, there were situated the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. So there was sent Hazrat Lut alayhi salam. So all these nations, they were known to these people. But because the nation of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam lived high up in the north, in that area which is today called Kurdistan, part of it is in Turkey, part of it is in Iraq, part of it is in Iran, and some of it is in Armenia. So this was higher up. So the Arabs, they didn't know the history of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, تِلْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهَا إِلَيْكَ مَا كُنْتَ تَعْلَمُهَا أَنْتَ وَلَا قَوْمُكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ هَذَا. You didn't know them, nor yourself, nor your nation, before this. فَاسْبِرْ. So, O Muhammad, have patience, persevere. Because the result will be the same. You will be helped. You will be delivered. You and people who have come to believe with you, we shall help them. Our help shall come to them. إِنَّ الْعَاقِبَةَ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the happy end are for those who fear Allah, who are God conscious, who regard Allah, who believe in Him, who love Him, and who spend everything for His pleasure. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.